My name is Ancor, and I'm here to talk about some hidden gems we have in the openSUSE project. I work for SUSE. I have been involved in the openSUSE community for something like 3 years now. And I guess that the first question, if you ask somebody what openSUSE is, the answer you will get most often is that it's a Linux distribution. That's factually right, but it's actually not completely precise, or at least it's not, you know, the whole truth. The point is that openSUSE is an open source community, so it's an open source project. The original distribution was, or the original goal was to create an awesome Linux distribution. And I will say we are doing pretty well since we now produce several awesome Linux distributions like openSUSE Lib, openSUSE Tumbleweed, or EduLife, for example. But all those distributions are just the outcome of it. Actually, the central piece of the whole thing is people. So something you can be sure, if you put some people together, some creative people that have a common interest in software development and in technology in general, and you provide them with channels so they can communicate with infrastructure they can play with, at some point, some things will start happening. That's something you can take for granted because, you know, geeks never sleep. So that's exactly what is happening in the openSUSE community. There is a lot of people who have whatever needs, and they are just creating software to fulfill their own needs. And then they are talking to others, and all those small projects are finding like a perfect breeding ground on openSUSE to evolve, and can use openSUSE as a vehicle to reach more resources and more people, and finally become something useful for more people. One great example, in my opinion, of that philosophy is what openSUSE does with the Google Summer of Code. I guess you all know what Google Summer of Code is, but it's a global program by Google. So some students all over the world get a sponsor to work during the whole summer coding in some free software project. And openSUSE has been involved in GSOC, in Summer of Code, for several years. And although we use it, of course, to improve our distribution, I think there is this year a project about rewriting the one-click installer that is mentored by Antonio. What we usually do is to use the openSUSE organization as some kind of umbrella for all those small projects that couldn't be able by themselves to access the Google Summer of Code. And you can check that page, 101openSUSE.org/GSOC, and see that we have 6 projects approved this year. And actually, we have many of those students coming here to the openSUSE conference. That was really nice. And even some of them, I think they can be here because they are sponsored by the openSUSE Travel Super Program. And we have had great time with them. We, the mentors, have learned a lot from them on these couple of days. And so in the presentation, in some projects, you will see this kind of stamp, this yellow logo there. That means that this particular project is actually taking part this year in our Summer of Code. So you can expect to become even better. So let's start talking about all those hidden gems. If you have been around for some time, first thing you think, if you listen somebody saying, I'm an openSUSE contributor and I'm going to speak about the software we produce beyond the distribution, you probably say, oh my, he's going to talk about OBS and openQA again. And actually I do, because there are great examples of this idea I'm trying to explain. Both is, all those projects started like tools, and we are really proud of them, started tools for creating the distribution, but are much more than that. Even if you go to 3Ws openSUSE.org, first thing you will find is our 2 main distributions, but right below, we have a tools section with openQA on OBS because, yeah, we are proud of how we create software that goes farther. For example, OBS is being used by several organizations. We even had a presentation yesterday about a company called Copano and how they use OBS for their goals. Something similar happened with OpenQA. It started like a pet project of Berhan to test Factory, and now it's being used to test Tumbleweed, openSUSE Lib, SUSE Enterprise, Fedora. And if I didn't misunderstand completely yesterday, Martin, I think that they are even considering to use it for testing KDE. So it's that kind of things, but you already know all that. So let's focus on, younger projects, let's say. First one I would like to highlight is the one you have been using extensively during the last days, because it's the software that powers this conference. So when we were checking the landing page conference to see what was all about, when you were registered and told the organizer what was the size of your t-shirt, for example, if you are a speaker, when you were submitting your papers, or all those days that you have been struggling with the schedule, back and forward, trying to attend as many talks as possible, all that is powered by OSEM. And even further, all the experience, let's say, it gives to attendants, it also gives a lot of power to the conference organizers, like, so they can coordinate, they can check if people that is registered is already there, they have a lot of stats to see how everything is going, so it's really an all-in-one solution to organize free software events and free software conferences. And that's the URL, that's a screenshot of the part that you usually don't see because you are attendees in this case. And as you can see, there is a yellow stamp there. That means that we are improving it a bit further this year. As we are doing also with the next project, which is Portus. Before going forward, I should say that I'm not a Docker expert. And this project and the next one is about Docker. I'm not even a Docker user. But the bright side is that starting today, we have the Docker meetup here. So there will be actually a presentation about Portus and a presentation about the next project by their own creators in the seminar rooms up there. So just go to OSEM, check the schedule, and attend if you want to know more. But as I understand Portus, when you have a big infrastructure with Docker, at some point you need to manage several Docker images. Most likely you will like to have for that your local instance of the Docker registry. But that Docker registry does not provide any authentication mechanisms or something like that. And that's exactly what Portus does. It sits on top of the Docker registry or next to it or whoever you want to paint it and provides authentication so you can integrate a Docker registry with the rest of the infrastructure. And it also provides users and groups and you can assign permissions to users and groups for the images and all that. And it also provides this beautiful user interface which, if I'm not mistaken, is exactly what they are improving with Summer of Code. They got a student to improve the interface even further. And the other Docker project we have around that is interesting if you are working with Docker is the zypper-docker. It's, as I see it, is a nice attempt to bring together both worlds, the distributions and the typical approach to security that we have in distributions, like releasing maintainers and date, and then maintaining them with zypper and all those tools, to the idea of having all those Docker images are there, so you can really test for all your Docker images which security updates are missing, and you can apply them all. There you can see a screenshot. It's a text application, but well, still you see a screenshot in which they are listing all the patches that need to be applied and with all the information, and it really feels like working with zypper. I think that Mikkel will have a presentation today, so just attend if you want to know more. And this is a project actually I can speak about because I know it much better. This one started in the Just team. We wanted to have video calls, but we didn't want to use, of course, any proprietary solution. We didn't want to have strange plugins in our browsers or to host our conversation in some company out there. So we were looking for solutions to have our meetings with a self-hosted solution. But we are quite a big team. We are 15 people. And most solutions we found really couldn't cope well with big rooms. So what we did was to create our own solution. And we have been using it for a year now. We use it in the whole company. There are several teams that are using it. We open-sourced everything from the very beginning, of course. You have it only use standard WebRTC mechanisms. So you just need Firefox or Chromium, or Chrome, I guess, or I'm not sure which other browsers work. But we tested with Chromium and Firefox. You can share your screen. So you have a screen sharing, a text chat, and the typical things you will expect from this kind of solutions. Right now, we are using it with big teams, several teams on the same server at the same time, and it seems to work. If you want to play a little bit with it, we have a demo server in Jangouts.tk to see if it works for you. Then you can install your own server. And it's also been improved this summer of code. Another really nice project you can find on this OpenSUSE umbrella is Machinery. It's a command line application, but I took that beautiful image from the homepage. And actually, a homepage is worth a visit. Even if you don't know what the software is about, the homepage is already worth a visit because it's a really nice one. And it's a software that allows you to examine a machine and understand the whole configuration and the whole thing, and then you can do a lot of things with this information. All those bubbles around there represent all the things you can do with that information. For example, you can check the status of the configuration of a machine and compare that with a previous state or with another machine that is probably running a different distribution, but still you want to make sure that they are configured in a way that is kind of equivalent. You can use it as the first step to introduce a configuration management system like Salt or Puppet. There's actually in the web page they have a lot of use cases, and yes, as is usually said, sky is the limit. Really, they really make a lot of creative use of it. And I would like to finish encouraging you to use the question round to tell me about other projects that I overlooked, to blame me for overlooking them, because, well, I had to make everything fit in 15 minutes, and I was even not sure if I was going to have as much time. So, as I said, now it's time for you to speak up if you have a question about any of the projects. Hopefully, we have enough people here to answer them, not only me, because I don't know all of them that well. Or just tell me what I overlooked or whatever. So, time for you.
So we have all these hidden gems, but why are they actually hidden? Why doesn't the world know about them? I think we should be better in marketing these efforts. I come from a Fedora background, even though I now work for SUSE. And in Fedora, we have had so many projects which are standalone outside the Fedora infrastructure now, which have become really successful. And in SUSE, I see we have so many, in SUSE and openSUSE, we have so many awesome tools, but the marketing is not basically non-existent. So what do you think we need to improve?
Actually, I don't know, because I'm a developer, and that's the main problem, I guess, that these tools are created by people that only cares about coding, or, you know, it's all of them started to fix a particular problem that somebody had. So the problem is fixed. It's everything open source. We do our best. I mean, the little part of the world of trying to document and open, but yeah, I completely agree. It's something we need to fix. That's why I'm here today. But yes, we need to do even more. But I don't know what.
Okay, we have to conclude the Q&A session because the next speaker is actually up.
Thank you then.